It's easy to get so caught up in the details that you miss the big picture. We do it all the time with our families, at work, in our fights, in our daydreams. And we do it with Bible stories too. It's not terrible. It's just so easy to do. Like today's gospel, there's Jesus and thousands of hungry people. And they're hungry for healing and for good news in the world of the opposite. They are hungry for someone to hear, to listen, to offer hope. And I think we can relate to that. After a few weeks of hearing stories about North Korean missile launches and possible massive changes to our immigration system and sanctions against Russia, let alone whatever is going on in our own household, I think we can understand the disciples when they looked at all of the need around them in the crowd and all of the brokenness and all of the not enough. And they asked themselves, how can there ever be enough for all this mess, all this hunger, all this pain? And in the face of questions like that, we keep moving on to the story and we focus on Jesus and the wonderful action of feeding so many with what seems like so little. And the what of the miracle is important, but just as important is the why. Jesus feeds the crowd, Jesus has compassion, we know that. But why? Jesus didn't have to do it that way. We live in a culture that tells us, celebrates, that we pull ourselves up from our bootstraps and that when things get tough, that you get tougher and you work harder and you keep a smile on your face while you're doing it. The world at large doesn't care about those who are hungry, those who are crossing the borders of other countries to find safety from drug lords and gangs and violence, those who suffer abuse at the hands of family members, church officials, or total strangers, or those who struggle with mental illness, whether publicly or in their own personal hell. There are so many folks that this world doesn't care about. And then there's Jesus. Jesus had compassion on the crowds, on all of them. And in Jesus, we have the clearest picture of just what kind of God we have. And it's a picture of a God who actively cares, a God who, when the disciples Jesus, they don't have anything to offer. Jesus tells them to get over themselves, that it's time for dinner, and to get busy serving the guests. Now, Jesus is most often the guest of someone else's meal in the Gospels. But today he's the host. And the next time he will host a meal, it will be in an upper room where Jesus will do what he has always done. Break the bread of life so that there is enough for everyone. Because when you love someone, you give yourself away for them. We are told that these thousands of people who are with Jesus are there because they're in need. They need his help and they need his hope. And Jesus' compassion for them goes beyond teaching, beyond healing. He wants to show them how much he loves them. Maybe Jesus was a secret Lutheran because eating and healing together is the best way to get to know people, right? It's why we do dinners here at Living Waters. There comes a stage in any relationship when we say, let's eat together. This is how we indicate we want a relationship to develop. It's all very well chatting with people at work or at ShopRite or coffee hour, but if you really want to get to know someone, you eat with them. Eating together is about renewing and deepening the way we know each other. And today's story about eating gives us a picture of God, who also shows us that being a follower of Jesus always comes with the invitation to act, to take a leap of faith, to think outside the box, and to see abundance where the world only sees scarcity. Now, can any one of us or one community of faith feed every hungry person in the world? Of course not. Jesus didn't even try to do that. But what we do get to do is is use the resources we have in faith. And usually by the end of that early adventure, a miracle happens in some shape or form. Today's gospel miracle started with Jesus telling the disciples, "You do it." Pastor Caroline Lewis of Luther Seminary says in that one simple statement, Jesus is saying, live already. You can't sit back and watch me do all this awesome stuff. You go live it. I'm counting on you, and I need you. Today's gospel is a picture of God who in Jesus tells us to bring what we have, no matter how little we think it is. Bring it to the table, and in doing so, we will be fed and forgiven along with everyone else. We will eat together, not alone, but connected by something bigger and stronger than anything that could divide us. Today's gospel is a picture of a God who used even the reluctant disciples to care for the poor and hungry that God loves so much. And that miracle continues today. When one student stands up against the bullying of another, when a struggling community of faith makes a promise to help a refugee family and all the baggage that comes along with it, when a friend takes intentional time to check in on someone who is struggling, whether physical or mental health, the God of compassion is again miraculously revealed. And God is still at work performing miracles through disciples like you and me, who can be eager, reluctant, or everything in between. Miracles that easily rival those reported in today's reading. Because the real wonder of this story is that it continues. God still cares deeply and passionately for those who are most vulnerable. The poor, the immigrants, the hungry, the hurting. And God continues to use us to care and to walk with them, and sometimes with ourselves when we find ourselves there. Our God is still working miracles of compassion every day, still changing lives, still working against all odds, still showing us generosity that makes a difference, still making sure there is bread.